Going to learn about the event structure, and event structure is really very beautiful and smart and strong programming concept. From today, whatever you will design that car movement program, that gravity control program, any kind of program. Suppose you will design, I will give you the homework for the calculator development or that bottle shifting from one place to each and everywhere you need event structure. Why? Because you want to control. You want to perform your code as per your control. Okay. So now, look at here. So whatever the programming till today you have learned, that programming was only based on the polling methodology. From today we will learn about the event structure. Earlier programming methodology was the polling based programming, polling methodology. And today's programming is event based programming. So what is the difference? Look at here in this program. Only look at this program. After this, when I will run the program, so my code will not wait for my any user interactions. It will start execution. For any kind of user interaction or any kind of required data, if this condition terminal is satisfying, so it will start execution. It will not wait for anybody. Let's see for the slow update rate. I can give here 70 millisecond delay and run. Now you can see this loop is start execution. This loop is not waiting for anybody. No matter user is ready for the performance, user is waiting for any kind of the output, each and everything is useless. Only one thing is important. If you press the simulation button, so it will start simulating each and every time. And that is the drawback of the normal programming platform. And that is the biggest drawback of any kind of programming language. Why? Because your program is not waiting for, suppose any kind of things. You want to use hair dryer without, okay, or you want to use any you want to use washing machines. You just switch on your plug and your system will start working. Then that will be very difficult to you each and every time. We have control units. Okay, so today we are going to learn that concepts. Look at here. Right click, come into the while loop and take a while loop and place here. Right click, come into the structure and take a while loop and place here. Inside the while loop, I am taking a event structure. By default, event is a timeout. Event is a kind of case structure with the some extra benefits. Yes, ma'am. Silent. Event has a extra benefit. Event is just kind of case structures with some filter node and timing VIs. Using event structure, when you will use the event structure, so that will not affect your speed of your PC, CPU. So shall we start? Look at here. In this event structure, the by default is time. By default is timeout. So what is the event? What is the event? A event is a use. Okay, any object click by user. Event is any object click by user. First, event is any object click by user. A timing hardware, any programming setup, or any other kind of the user interference. You can okay, you can set your event using the user click. When you will click the button, then your user platform, sorry, your event will activate. Or after some minute, after half an hour, after 10 minutes, your event will activate. After 5 days, your particular event will activate. That will come under the event structure. And really, event structure will teach you so many things. So now, it is timeout. Right now, by default, timeout is minus one because minus one timeout will never meet. Whenever you will start working, every time your time will be increased. Never go back to the minus. So this minus one is timeout. Look at here. Here I am going to create. Here I am going to create indicators. And here I am going to create a control and going to run. Now you can see it will not generate any value. Why? Because it is waiting for an event. There is no any simulation process has been begun inside this while loop. Now while loop is not a master. Now event structure is a master. There is no any kind of simulation process it has start inside the event. I cannot also stop this program. Why? Because the stop function is not registered in the event structure. When you will use event and you want to control event, so you need to register your functions. So now we need to abort the program. Now look at here. I am going to right click here. And add event keys. What? Add event keys. Right click in a border and add event keys. When you will open the add event keys, so you will get edit event dialog box. In this edit event dialog box, first you will get the event case. So first event case is timeout. That is the system defined. That is the application defined. System defined. But now I want to create the event. And what is my objectives? Which object I can control? Numeric or stop? Definitely we can control numeric, sorry, stop only. Why? Because numeric is an indicator. So now in the event specifier, we need an event source and event. What is the meaning of source? Where and from this which location event is occurring? From which portion or from which location or from which object or from where, how the event is occurring, that is the event source. So here the events will be my stop. And what kind of event? So the button press value change, button press value change, that will be my event. So here I am going to click the value change. So event source is stop and event is value change. Okay, only one event I am going to enter registered here. Now you can see if I will run the program, so now it's running. It generated the value 0 and it generated false. Now it's stopped. Now it's waiting. Now it's waiting continuously for any kind of user. Okay, it is waiting. Timeout is minus 1. Timeout is minus 1. That means there is no time elapse. As per the timing, means it is what can I immortal, Amar. No one can stop this program. Only and only when user will interact something, then it will be, then program will stop. So look at here, when I will click the stop button, okay, then it will be, then its count, the count has been increased and one. Count has been increased to one. When I will click it again, so program will stop. Look at here, by default is zero, when I will press one, so now program has been stopped. Okay, look at here. Now here I am going to drag these functions inside. I am going to drag this function inside stop functions here. And here I am going to create constant and that will be true. Okay, no. I am taking one true constant. True constant. Okay. Look at here. I am taking one increment function. Increment. 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 Okay. It is increment function. Look at here, all of you. Increment functions. Right click. Add event case. Increment is my controller. Value change, that will be event. Okay. I am going to create a shift register. I am going to take one increment functions. And now indicator. Anywhere I can plot it. Look at here, sir and ma'am. Dear sir, ma'am, look at here. I am going to run the program. There is no changes in numeric one. There is no changes in the increment. Now when I will press the increment button, so now it's increased once. Now still it's waiting. When I will press it increment again, so loop will run one more time. Now when I will press the increment, so now loop has run 4 times. That's why my increment value is 4. Loop is 5 times. If I will press the stop button, so program will stop. If I will run, so it will wait. We are not using any timing VI. We are not forcing our CPU to wait till n millisecond or elapse n millisecond, then come back and talk to me. We are not. We are doing only one thing. We are using event structure, and this event structure will wait till any event will occur. Are you getting concepts?
Yes.
Any other? Now here inside the timing VI, I am going to put here the 5000 millisecond. That means the 5 seconds. If user will not enter anything or user will not perform any action till 5 seconds, then program will abort. Then program will stop. Then program will stop. And if you want, so we can display due to time out. Due to time out. Due to time out. Or due to press stop. Okay. Run the program. 5 seconds, I will not do anything. Let's see what is generating. Program will abort automatically. Numeric is 0 and timeout. It's also, this numeric is not updating. Okay, anything. Run the program. Increment, increment, increment. Stop. Due to press stop button. To further more concept, decrement, decrement. Please check the spelling. Decrement. Here the decrement function is here. Right click. Add event. Decrement is a functions. OK. And place here. And take a decrement button. And take a decrement button and place here. Now I am taking one move button. Clear. C-L-E-A-R, clear. C-L-E-A-R, clear. Okay. So where is my output? Where is my output? This one is my output. Right click, add event, clear event, okay event, okay, come here, zero, run the program, increment, okay, decrement, is going to reduce the value, decrement, because decreasing, clear, it's again clear, increment, decrement, clear, decrement, increment, clear, clear, increment, decrement. How many time I click the button? 43 times. Increment. How many time my loop has been done? 45 times. Increment, 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 decrement, decrement, decrement. Clear. Now, let's see when the program will stop due to timeout. Please try to write this code. Take the 5 to 10 minutes. Understand. Then we'll go to the next step and we'll see how can we control other things and logics. Have you done? Please take your time, design step by step. Whatever the problem if you will face, ask me, I will teach you, because if you are not good in event, so you are not good in the programming. Whatever I teach last 20 days, that is completely useless if you are not able to use event structure. Today, tomorrow, and day after tomorrow. This, okay? This is very important. Okay, now tell me, have you done this timeout? Please join this timeout. Siddhant,
please.
There's Rich. Uma Chandel. Surya Chandu. After timeout, go to the stop and create a stop. If you are not okay, here I am going to display each and every event one by one. Just a second. It is the event for the stop, it is a stop. For decrement, it will be a decrement. For increment, okay, for clear, we have 5 cases. Anybody have you done, sir? A man? Siva, Konar, okay. Now, if you have done, so I am going to delete this portion only and going to save this program with the name of event one, event example. Not here, summer date. Event. Now here I am going to create one file. I am going to create one file here. Okay, and file will be open a open Excel file. Open an Excel file okay and save in the form of .csv, save as .csv. Day 24 data. Base and dot CSV, that will be the this CSV, not Macintosh, MS DOS. Yes, Now I'm going to close it. Okay, come to the lab view, open a new VI. Click open a new VI. Right click, take a file path. Take a file path, set the browse options, file or folder, new or existing. Okay. File folder, new or existing. Have you done? Right click. Select the database. Select the database. Right click. Come into the file. Take a right spreadsheet file and place here. Format will be the string constant and it will be percent s small s only. Take a string, create a string array constant. Create a string array constant. Name. Location location name location date of birth okay and anything one more location anything college name name okay comma let's take this comma space comma or comma okay type delimiters comma have you done now right click name, location, date of birth, time stamp, and final your college name. Now, as a mature programmer, we will fit all these things inside a array, sorry, inside a cluster. Now, here I am going to take one function that will be stop. Going to take one going to take here save. Okay. Now, take one more, read. Okay, later we will take read. Only two functions. Now, right click, come here, take a while loop. It is right delimited functions. I am going to switch off. Now, right click, come here, take a event structure. Timeout will be the 1000 millisecond, 10,000 millisecond means you know 10 second. If you want, so you can keep it minus one without any problem. No one will harm you. Now, right click, add event, stop, add event, stop, okay, right, keep this stop inside, true constant, right click, add, save, place here, keep cluster here. If you want, so you can keep here, also here, doesn't matter. Right click, replace the cluster. Okay. Now there is functions cluster to array, cluster data to array. Sorry. Okay, no problem. So what can we do? Cluster data to array. Okay. Right click. Unbundle by name. Unbundle by name. Name. Location DOB. Okay. I think this DOB data birth function is the is it, this function is present in the form of string. So now I can increase the size. I can take this function string to temp date time to string converter. Now take a build array functions, build array. Create label. So what we can do here, sorry, it is a build array functions. It is string to date time, formatted string to date time function is this one. College name here, the fourth number. Okay, let's try to check the program. No, this one thing is remaining. Appendant, create constant, appendant true. And let's try to take create constant, appendant true. Run. NITES at Nitesh. PRADHAN Pradhan, sorry, Nitesh, location Delhi. Date and time, set time now. Okay, college name NIT, save it. After that, Bhavesh Puchu. Okay. Save it. Now I'm going to stop the program. Let's try to open and check the database is working or not. Okay, it's properly working without any problem. So there is one only problem which I didn't consider, and the problem is here, delimiters. I passed forward this one. Okay, so let's see. Okay, now run the program. Okay. File is already open, so we need to save the program. Don't save. I will check it and I double click and open. Then what I will get? Okay. Delete. Save it. Now run Bhavesh Puchu. Okay, next NITES Nitesh Delhi. NIT, save it. you guess R yes, save it, stop and go. It's working great. Now read. READ, read. Read. Control A, Control U. Okay. Now I'm going to write one more program, that is a read program. Read program. So read is here. Right click. Add event case. Read. Okay. Place here. I don't need any resources extra. Only read program. Read. Just a second. Okay, read. Label format will be string. Here the format will be the Control S string. And now here delimiter is present in the middle of section, constant. Okay, now right click, create indicator. Right click, create indicator. Look at here, please, all of you. Look at here once. Right click. Here. Right click. Okay. Create property node. Visible. Click here. Sorry. Create, change to write. Here true, outside it's false. Now what I am trying to do and what I am trying to teach you, please look at here. Run the program. Okay, I'm going to again save. Now if I want to read, save, read. Okay, no problem, I can take it outside. Run, come in the front panel. Save, read. Okay. Now, if I will write something, HJ TS save, read. save it. Okay. Now, if you want, so you can update the memory as you want. Okay. Here, I am going to set the arrows, array size, and others. Look at here. Create property node, number of column, and number of row. Right click. I am dragging it. Right click. Change all to right. Right click. Sorry, right click here. All of you, you can follow here. Mathematics. Algebra, matrix, matrix size, I can connect here, number of row, connection, number of column, connections. Now, coming to the front panel, control T, run, save it, read, only two lines. Okay. Save, read, three line. Now we are able to control all these things. It's clear. Siddhan, please try.
Yes, sir.
Any update from anybody? Have you done this program is working for you?
Yes, sir. Sir, please show the save event.
Sir, save.
Which event? Save event. This, okay. Save event. I will share one video, event-based data equations. I will share some video related to the event. Please try, please watch and try to design. And then I will share you one project that is the calculator design. Basic calculator development project I will share you. You can learn so many things. And after that, I will share you one. Designed calculator project. Okay, you have to reverse engineering to learn more. Yes, sir. Siddhant.